Hello all, this is Sobroni, and welcome back to our second episode of our Persona 5 Let's Play. It's the cardboard box sent from back home. It's full of clothes and daily necessities. I'll change into more comfortable clothes for now. Oh wow, we're on fleek. We're rocking some crazy clothes right now. So we left off with our asshole caretaker. Some parts of these shelves have rust on them. All these difficult looking books were carelessly crammed in it. Our asshole caretaker basically stuffing us in the attic. I don't want to go to sleep. And he's just a huge douchebag that needs a car rammed through his cafe. It's a desk with a stack of books on top. No one can use this as a desk while it's like this. I should start cleaning first. Fuck it. I can't concentrate in the dirty room, so let's clean that shit. This is such a Persona vibe to it too, because it's like all this mundane, random stuff happening. But like, if you really break it down, Persona is half the game RPG insanity, and then the other half of the game is just mundane, everyday stuff. Like, literally, just spend the whole day cleaning. Sure, why not? It's late. Seems like I've been cleaning for a while.
Seriously?
What the heck? I heard you making all sorts of this is the voice I attributed to him, by the way. I heard you making all sorts of noise up here, but I didn't think you were cleaning. Why didn't you? You thought I was a fucking slob or something? Actually, this place doesn't look too bad. He's about to kick me out now and send me to the basement. Though it's only natural you'd want to tidy up your room. Why don't you go to bed for tonight? You don't have anything better to do. I just want to kill him. I'm going to close up shop and get out of here myself.
I'm going to head back then.
I won't be the one looking after you if you get sick from staying up too late. Got that? Dude, you're going to like... I hope this is like... sleeping in your bed moving forward one day. So that's... Alright, so just like in real life, you want to avoid sleeping at all costs. How to advance time? Going to bed is a special action that will change or that will advance time. This is limited. Think carefully about your schedule before you act. The tutorial for this should just be... go about your day as normal in real life. Cluttered work desk. I might be able to use this as a desk to remove the books. So they're forcing me to. I don't want to waste a day. I should call it a day and just go to sleep. Ah. Not, you see, now it's bothering me because I feel like if I had chosen not to clean, I could have done something outside and met somebody, and like the whole story would have been different. Starting today, this is my room. Damn, that's gonna irk me, because in the back of my mind, I'm like, I could have left this place a mess and met, like, I don't know who, my soulmate. Arrest, trial, criminal record.
Damn brat, I'll sue!
Still, I couldn't just let that go. That day, I had to go home early. Oh, cool. This is a flashback within a flashback. That's dope. I can dig it.
Just get in the car.
This is actually kind of... this is from a literary or from a narrative perspective. This is kind of cool. It puts you in the action and in the mindset of him when he experienced this. I can hear a man and a woman arguing in the distance. I think they're just up ahead. I don't know if you guys can hear it.
How dare you cross me?
But like, the ambiance is really, really convincing. Like, I really feel like I'm in the situation, and it's really, I feel the awkwardness of the situation. Like, part of me just wants to be like, I see nothing and walk away. But I don't know, I just feel that guilt. The music, the score is so great in Persona games. I really think that that's the effect of the music.
Don't give me that shit.
The dialogue is good too. It looks like that drunk man is bothering that woman.
No, please stop.
She's in danger. Even the choices are like literally your only choice is to save her, because this is like your memory, so you can't. I have to save her. I'm really liking it so far. Like, this is like we're not even in the action of time, and I'm already liking this.
You think you're worth causing me trouble, huh?
I'll call the police.
Call them if you want. The police are my bitches. They're not gonna take you seriously.
Police are my, that is totally gonna be, unless something better comes along, that is the episode title.
No! Stop!
I don't know, I might trigger someone with that episode title though. Certain co-host of mine.
Get in the car! Incompetent fools like you just need to shut your mouths and follow where I steer this country.
I feel like making a political joke. insert political commentary here.
What are you looking at? Get out of my face. This ain't a show. You're lost, kid. See? This is all because you're so damn slow. Get in the car.
This is a really, really, like, bossy assaulter. Like, Jesus, he just barks orders at people. He's not even, he don't have time for that shit. It's that weird app that somehow ended up on my phone. What apps do you have on your phone? Alright, that's clearly a WhatsApp, Snapchat, or is that just your camera? Whatever. I can stare at this all day. The icon looks almost like an eye. I thought I deleted it. No, it's so creepy. Delete that shit. It's a virus. We don't need that kind of malware on our phones. My eyelids are starting to get heavy. Next thing you know, his identity is going to be stolen. That's how it starts. Little girl cops? Yep. Creepy little girl twin cops. Sure, why not? Is persona. Well, let's go. It begins.
Welcome to my velvet room.
I like the other velvet room better. It was less hostile.
So you've come too, inmate. The you in reality is currently fast asleep. You are only experiencing this as a dream.
You're in the presence of our master. Stand up straight!
Welcome. I am delighted to make your acquaintance. This place exists between dream and reality, mind and matter. It is a room that only those who are bound by a contract may enter. I am Igor, the master of this place. Remember it well.
Where's your other assistant?
I summoned you to speak of important matters. It involves your life as well.
Nah, I'm trying to get out of here.
Know your place, inmate! Who do you think you're talking to?
Still, this is a surprise. The state of this room reflects the state of your own heart. To think a prison would appear as such. You truly are a prisoner of fate. In the near future, there is no mistake that ruin awaits you. Haha, worry not. There is a means to oppose such a fate. You must be rehabilitated toward freedom. That is your only means to avoid ruin. Do you have the resolve to challenge the distortion of the world?
Yeah, I'd rather avoid ruin.
Allow me to observe the path of your rehabilitation. Pardon me for not introducing the others. To your right is Caroline. To your left, Justine. They serve as wardens here.
Yeah, I'm totally gonna call them Caroline and Justine.
Try and struggle as hard as you like. The duty of wardens is to protect inmates. We are also your collaborators. That is, if you remain obedient.
I shall explain.
Shit, they have sharing guns too.
At another occasion. Now then, it seems the night is waning. It is almost time. Take your time to slowly come to understand this place. We will surely meet again, eventually.
Time's up! Now hurry up and go back to sleep!
So does being asleep in Velvet Room make mean I wake up in real world? I don't know, I kind of like the metaphysical aspect of that whole, the Velvet Room reflects what your heart is. I had a strange dream, ruin, rehabilitation, what does it mean?
Hey.
Looks like you're up.
Well.
Well then, let's go introduce ourselves properly to the staff about your transfer. I see you put on your pimp robe, sir. The school you're attending is in the Aoyama district. It'll cost you a bit to ride the train there, and the route transfers are a pain. I'll drive you there, but just for today, let's go. You're such a tsundere. That's what you are. You're just tsundere. Sheesh, men aren't usually allowed in my passenger seat. Yeah, you tsundere motherfucker. Yeah, I know what you are. Is this one of my romance partners? Can I go his route? Can I go the Sakura route?
Do me a favor and behave yourself, alright? Don't get me wrong. I don't care what happens to you.
Oh my god, I'm going the Sakura route, aren't I?
Just don't cause me any trouble.
The Sojido route. The Sojido Sakura route.
To reiterate, just so we're clear, you will immediately be expelled if you cause any problems. Honestly, I hesitated on accepting someone like you. But there were some circumstances on our side. You might have done a variety of things in hiding in your hometown, but you will behave yourself here. If you are thrown out from our school, there will be no place for you to go. Keep that in mind.
Note to self, never save anyone because you will get non-stop shit for it, apparently.
I'm Sadayo Kawakami. Here's your student ID.
Thank you, Android woman.
Be sure to read the school rules. Any violations will send you straight to the guidance office. And if by chance you cause any problems, I won't be able to protect you at all.
Yeah, the teachers suck. We
that
can't protect
you. That is your promise, yes, Principal Kobayakawa?
Mm-hmm. He is responsible for all his actions.
Can I... Aw, man. If I could pull out a gun right now, they're responsible for this. Bop!
But really, though... Why me? There should have been better candidates.
It was a sudden transfer, and your class was the only one that had an opening.
Let's discuss this in front of the kid.
If you're done explaining things, mind if we get going?
I hope this guy has high self-esteem, because he's just been getting shitted on for the past...
Sakura-san, please keep a close eye on him. Don't let him cause any trouble outside.
He will, but it's not because he wants to, Baka.
Well... I'll be sure to have a serious talk about the situation he's in.
Come to the faculty office when you arrive at school tomorrow. I'll show you to your classroom.
Don't even bother. I don't want you to. I don't want to deal with any of you guys. Except my waifu, Sojiro. They're treating you like some kind of nuisance. So are you! I guess that's what it means to have a criminal record. Turns out your past follows you wherever you go. By the way, if you get expelled now, I won't hesitate to kick you out. Got it? I'll be careful. I gotta be nicer to him because he's a potential romance partner, I guess. School never changes, huh? Fuck, I forgot to give him his voice. Come on, we're going. Well, now that I know he's a tsundere, I gotta give him a different voice, actually. I gotta do my best Rie impression.
What a troublesome situation.
Jersey-wearing teacher.
I can't believe they pushed someone with a record on me. Male teacher would be better suited for this.
That is sexist.
Why in the world was someone like that admitted here?
Who knows? It was the principal's decision. I was told that it's for the school's reputation.
I would have thought that my volleyball team has contributed more than enough to cover that.
That's certainly true.
Be careful, okay? Then again, if anything were to happen, I'd kick out a student like that right away.
Yeah, we don't want these anti-rape students on the campus. What'll happen if he stops a if he stops another rape?
I keep wishing that he'd just end up not coming to school. Still, that isn't something I should be saying as a teacher.
Your word, you need to get, like, your license revoked.
Well, I should be returning to practice.
Oh, right. The tournament's coming up, isn't it?
Having such high expectations placed on you by others is quite a problem in itself.
I'm so
we'll
awesome.
Have to work hard to make up for the track team, too.
Haha, track team is shit.
Yes, that's true.
I feel like she's gonna go home and just tweet about how much she hates the new student. Yeah, go home and tweet about it so you get fired. No, you'll probably get promoted in this environment.
Oh, traffic's not moving at all. You're taking the train starting tomorrow. So, how was it? The school, I mean. Think you can manage?
Yo, I want his pimp outfit. Well, it definitely doesn't seem fun. We'll see.
Now listen up. Don't even think of doing anything stupid. Still, you were expelled once already. To think you'd re-enroll in a different one. It's not like anyone will be sympathetic with you. That's what it was like at school. People might say stuff about me in the future, too. What a troublesome kid I've taken in.
Why did you take me in, Senpai?
I was asked to do it, and I just happened to agree to it.
Don't read too much into it, Baga.
I've already been paid for it, too, after all.
I'm shipping these two so hard.
A subway has derailed at Shibuya Station, greatly affecting the timetable all across the...
Oh, another accident. So that's why it's so crowded. There's been a lot of those lately.
It's almost like people were at your fucking cafe yesterday telling you about all the accidents happening. And you just ignored them and told them it's not a problem. So this is taking place in New York. Looks like the 4 train.
That was direct footage.
Clearly pulling into Grand Central.
According to the police, the engineer's life was not in danger despite his injuries. After questioning, even he could not explain his high speed when approaching the station. No further comments were made. Police are still looking for a plausible motive.
It's less of an operating accident and more of a crime of the company and the government. Site inspectors apparently reported all of this 6 months
ago. Penis head man.
The deterioration of the tracks and the ATC.
Is it supposed to literally, like, why is his head literally just look like a penis?
Both turned a blind eye to the truth. There's no way they can hide. This will go all the way to the top.
Now on to our main story. With this derailment accident, as well as other recent incidents of unknown motive, concern is spreading among the general public. Just what could be causing such a drastic change so suddenly in these people? SNN has...
Everything's linked. That's what you're thinking, correct?
Don't tell her what she's thinking, you sexist.
Oh, well. Are you free? You and I haven't gone for a drink in a while.
Thank you, sir. But I have another meeting to attend.
Also, very inappropriate.
Die. A noisy subway platform filled with people was suddenly...
rejected.
Did you ask for me? Is it a case?
Not quite. I want your opinion on something.
Oh, this is the prosecutor.
Sure. Your judgment is quite often correct, though.
I think.
Can we discuss this over?
I forgot what she looked
perhaps?
Like.
You are making a student work late, after all.
Conveyor belt only.
Oh. Yo, is everybody she meet just after her? Like, want to go for drinks? Want to go for sushi? Want to go for... I get it. She's cute. She's hot. But, you know, gotta tone it down a bit. Damn, to think there'd be so much that much traffic. What a waste of time. I wasn't able to open the cafe today. Missed out on a whole $5 I could have made.
Well,
whatever. Oh, don't you mean restaurant? It's not a cafe. It's a restaurant, right? Just head upstairs. There's something I need to give you.
Talk about a gruesome accident. 80 people were involved. It's a diary. Make sure you write in it. You may be under probation, but there's no special limitations on what you do in particular. Besides following the law, that is. However, I'm obligated to report on you, which is why I'm having you record your daily activities. Hey, what's up? I'm about to leave right now. Don't worry, I'll be there in no time. I'll see you soon.
Oh my god. I hope they let me write in the diary so I can just write obscene stuff in there.
I'll lock the place up. So do whatever you want for the rest of the night. Oh, but don't mess up my store. If something goes missing, I'll hand you right over to the cops. You got school tomorrow. You better head off to bed, alright?
Alright, you can't tell me like, oh, I need to take care of you and watch over you because I got a report on you. And then 5 minutes later be like, alright, do whatever you want. I don't really care. Just as long as you don't break my store or steal. I should do as I'm told for now. Getting conflicting messages from you, Sakura. And I am going to call him Sakura. I should write down what happened today in my diary. Saving. Oh, so it's a save button. You can save your... Oh, no, it's not. You can save your... Blah, 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 blah. I have an early day tomorrow. I should rest up.
Let's just add this. Save.
Fuck, I was going to say something and not completely forget what it was. Oh well. Dear diary, today everyone treated me like shit. The end. Can I sleep on the couch? Well, I don't even have a TV. Or a computer? What? What am I supposed to do? What am I literally supposed to do without a TV or a computer? That ringing sound isn't coming from my cell phone. I hear it coming from downstairs. Obey your instructions. Answer the phone. Well, I wasn't instructed to answer the phone. Yo, it's me. Who is this? Sheesh, you forgot my voice already? It's Sakura! I closed up shop, but I forgot to flip the sign to close. It's too much of a hassle for me to go back, so you flip the sign for me. Why'd you call a public phone? Sorry, I make it a habit not to save guys' numbers on my cell phone. Anyway, I'm glad you answered the phone over in the shop. Okay then, I'm leaving you in charge of the door sign. I'm really sensing the sexual tension between you guys. Just saying. How do I flip the sign? I'll have to go outside and go through the whole loading sequence just to flip a sign. How do I flip the sign? How do I flip the sign? Oh my god. How do I flip the sign? I want to get out of here. I'm failing my first mission. No. Alright, no. There has to be a way out here to flip the sign. I'm not going crazy right now. Okay. Alright. Sorry. I had my first panic attack, guys. It's like, wait. No. We're gonna be here for like 2 hours trying to figure out the flip the sign button. And I know Drew will back me up on this, that I'm horrible at following simple directions in games. So, it's especially in Pokemon. There'll be like somebody in Pokemon will tell you, like, bring this Pokeball to the guy over there, and I will be stuck there for 3 hours. Like, what the fuck do I do? Because I don't read. Transfer. It looks like I need to go out to Shibuya, then transfer there. Correction, actually, I do read. More news about that subway incident. It sounds like a lot of people were hurt. I bet this will affect the timetables for tomorrow, too. That strange app I saw last night is back. Keep showing up. Time to delete it again. I should probably reboot my phone just in case. I like the way this guy thinks. He knows. He knows a reboot is always necessary. My eyelids are starting to get heavy. As an IT person, I appreciate the little things like that. But yeah, no, I read. I just don't pay attention to like little simple commands like that. So I'm pretty sure they said, just go outside and flip the sign. And I totally, it went over my head. Like, I read it, and it just went over my head. I have school starting tomorrow. Hopefully I can get there without getting lost. I don't want to be late on my first day. I should head out now. Yeah, don't want to be late. Can I make you late? No, I can't. I want to make him like a delinquent though. Like, I really do. Oh, did you make me breakfast? Hey, hold on a minute. Oh, so you're actually going to school. Here, I'll feed you. Just make sure you finish it before some customers start coming in. This is my breakfast? Don't complain, just eat. Thank you, senpai. I can taste complex flavors within the bold spiciness. It's time for you to go. Thanks for the meal. Oh, no. That was delicious. Thanks. Head over to school. You'll end up late if you get lost on the way. First off, you ain't eating curry for breakfast. Oh, flip the sign outside. Oh, is there like a narrative reason for this? Like, don't forget to do that for me, alright? Now you better hurry on out or you're gonna be late if you get lost, country boy. Like, I don't know, maybe because it's Persona, so I'm doing this M. Night Shyamalan thing where I'm reading too much into stuff, but is he like the final boss and like he can't touch the sign because the sign is like cursed or something? Good morning. Oh, you must be that boy who's living in Boston. I was wondering who you were. You're a high school student, aren't you? You can't loiter if you want to make it to school. You should hurry on. I hear the trains are running late because of the accident yesterday. It was terrible. Just terrible. It was terrible. Just what is going on with the world? I should ask. No, no. In true male New York fashion, I will not ask for fucking directions. Look at that. And I got it right. Look at that. It's like I'm a New Yorker or something. No, let me on. Let me on. Okay. I like these little transitions too. These are really cool. There are so many people crammed into this tiny car. Turns out the rumors about the Tokyo subway are true. Think you mean the New York subway? They're showing the news up on the LCD screen. Oh, never mind. There's no way we have an LCD screen. It seems like there are still some lingering effects of the accidents of the yesterday's accident. LCD screen in New York subway.
Shibuya. This is Shibuya.
Half the trains don't even have air conditioner. Fucking LCD screen. Big Bang Burger. Word. That's where I'm going after school. I'm gonna have the Big Bang. Why is it late again? The accident was yesterday. Our apologies. However, it was a major accident, and this isn't the first time this happened. Why weren't you better prepared? Why weren't you better prepared for the derailing of a train? Why couldn't you have this problem fixed in a matter of minutes? Like, I'm judgy with the trains. Like, I'm an asshole with trains, but even that's kind of pushing it. Man, gotta get a life. Gotta get a life, bro. I kind of just want to walk around and see all these little... There's no mention of the Ginza line on the sign up there. I should look for it elsewhere. Ginza. Anyone from Japan want to tell me how accurate this train station is, by the way? I like little things like that. Like, I want to know how actually realistic to... like, the actual place it's inspired by, you know? Like, I want to see how much attention to detail it is. Something tells me that Persona pays a lot of attention to detail, so my guess is it's probably very accurate. We're in a Ginza? Does that say Ginza Line? There you go. See, like that sign up there said Ginza Line. And I was like, well, that's a good attention to detail. Look how big this train station is. I'm liking this. Like, I'm liking this little interaction. I like how I cut in front of all those people, too. Like, that's a huge train station.
Oh,
hope that comes into play later on where I can go to different areas.
Did it say it was going to rain
today? Huh? It's raining outside?
It just started all of a sudden. This is why I hate the early spring.
It reminds me.
It's very specific. You like mid and late spring, just not early spring.
Hmm? Who are you talking about?
Don't mind me. So, what'll it be?
One house blend, please.
The effects of yesterday's subway accident continues on today, as various lines suffer delay.
There's been a lot of nasty accidents lately. You know, I mean the subway accident that the news is talking about. My coworker got caught up in it and is in the hospital now. But that aside, it's kind of creepy.
Don't bother him, that's not his business, man. He doesn't want to hear about that.
These accidents supposedly went crazy all of a sudden. I heard that some of them suffered from nervous breakdowns during interrogation.
Huh.
That's all I've got to say. Sir, can you please provide a quote for the recent insane subway and car crashes that have been coming up? Huh. Thank you for your statement. This is Aoyama Yeah, it took some time, but I finally made it. Aoyama Ichome. You know what? I gotta go to Shinjun Academy. I think we're gonna end it here right now, so you know what, guys? Leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you really enjoyed this video, and I'm gonna catch you guys on our next video in episode 3. So until then, guys, later! So, I was going to end it, and then this cutscene started. I was trying to be swag and have the ending where I just like left through the turnstile and was like, alright guys, later, and fade to black. But fuck that, now we got a long ass cutscene, I guess. Instant waifu. Sorry, Sakura. Red's kind of loud. Could wear better tights than that, though.
Good morning. You want me to give you a ride to school? You're gonna be late.
Sure. Thank you.
Rape.
You need a lift, too?
Huh? Nah.
Here we see someone with the appropriate response to a stranger asking you if you want a ride in their car.
Teacher? Huh?
What do you want? You planning on ratting me out to Kamoshida?
Kamoshida.
Huh? In that car just now, it was Kamoshida.
All right, that's the asshole teacher.
Whatever the hell he wants. Who does he think he is? The king.
Forgot about him.
Don't you agree?
Well, smart ass away.
It's just a saying.
Hmm?
Wait, you don't know Kamoshida? Are you for real? You're from Shujin, right?
I think so.
You messing with me? You're wearing a Shujin uniform.
Yeah, let's fight.
Huh. A second year, huh? We're the same grade then. Never seen you before, though. Oh, you a transfer student? Then no wonder you don't know him.
So is this the Kanji of
it's raining
Persona 5?
Bad.
Was his name Kanji? I forget
up,
now.
We'll be late.
It's been so long since Persona 4.
head hurts. Damn it. I want to go home.
I was like, why is the time ticking up? Is the game over? Did I fail somehow? Was I not supposed to go to school today?
There was a terrible subway accident that day. You remember it, don't you? I assume you know of the uproar that the public calls the psychotic breakdown incidents.
Never heard of them.
That can't possibly be true. It was all over the news, and one of the victims included a teacher at your high school. I've no doubt you heard about it. On that day, were you still an ordinary student?
I actually really like the storytelling element. No quote, no response.
Let me change the question.
No comment.
You transferred to Shujin Academy, correct? An ordinary prep school that could be found in any city. That's what it should have been. What happened around that time? Tell me everything. Truthful.
Yeah, I'm really digging this this narrative style. This back and forth. And I'm really hoping this cutscene ends so I can save the game. Damn, I should have actually started the next recording with this. Maybe in post I'll edit this as the beginning of the- Nope, too late, I already commented over it. Fuck. Oh, that just means the last video is gonna be like 40 minutes.
What?
Huh? What?
We didn't come the wrong way, though. Yeah, this should be right.
I know I'm supposed to think that that's a strange sight, but it is Japan, and I thought it was a love hotel. I was like, where is this going? I already have Sakura. I can't be doing this, I didn't know this is a shonen ai. It looked like the Mickey Mouse logo. Or I guess I could call it the Disney logo. Watch me get copyrighted. Copyright by Atlas and Disney.
Weird. Where's the school?
I hope this is our school.
It should be. It said Shujin on the gate. What's going on here? Out of service. Where'd we end up?
Someplace without a save point.
The sign was for the school, right?
I was just walking aimlessly. I wasn't paying any attention to anything.
Jeez, you freaked me out. Who are you? You a student?
Oh, is that the school uniform?
Man, your costume's impressive. Is that armor real? Come on, don't just stand there, say
Hope
something.
Hope slices him in half.
Hey, what's going on?
I love being a smartass.
Dude, I don't know. Shit's real. Calm down. It's time out, man. We gotta run.
Don't tase me, bro.
Yeah, we better not mess with him. Go!
Fuck this. I want a persona. Let's mess with him. Maybe if they beat me up enough, I'll get my persona. No, beat me up. I want my persona.
You're gonna break my
bones. No, break my bones. I don't want him to have his persona. Yes, I would very much like to save my progress. So, with an additional, what was that, like 7 minutes or something? Yeah, 7 minutes on to the last episode, so now I think we're going to go over 40. But thank you guys for watching today's episode of Persona 5 LP. And like, comment, and subscribe as always. And I'll see you guys next episode. Thanks, everybody.